The House's Accountability Committee on Commissions, Statutory Authority and State Enterprises, chaired by Joel Senyonyi, continued with an inquiry into queries raised by the Auditor General's report 2020-2021 pertaining the Ugandan National Roads Authority. The committee questioned UNRA over delayed installation of lights on the Entebbe Expressway.
I am very concerned about the lighting and the darkness, although engineer team has submitted on that. But I want to know why it has taken all this long. Even before the road was opened, it was very clear that lighting was needed. So what could have been the challenge that we took like 4 years up to now?
The provision in the contract for the operator is to provide that lighting. We had some challenges at the beginning, especially associated with the COVID-19 lockdown and restrictions. But as we talk now, as an update, we have already received all the posts. Many of you who have used that road, they are piled there at Kajansi. We have received also the lamps. We, in our progress meetings, we have given them up to 30th December so that the entire road is lit.
Districts in this country have been through undefined poles, electric poles, you know, are lying there. They have, as an indicator that very soon electricity will come, 1 year elapses, 2 years elapse, and the poles are there as an indicator light is coming. So I don't know whether to be excited by this problem, because I've heard in the past within the media of a promise to light up this place because of the criminality there and so on and so forth. Now you're telling us December 30th.
The construction of the highway will cost government $476 million, an approximate to 1.8 trillion shillings, with a shocking cost of $9.2 million per kilometer. However, the road has registered a rampage of road carnage and highway robbery, especially in night hours.
That you're telling me December 30th, which is 1.5 months away. Because if you've had these gadgets since June, and people have been complaining about the darkness on this road, and you have been hearing the complaints, why? Why have we not put them up thus far?
Chair, the lamps and the poles are actually at the tail end. Those will be the last facilities to be installed for the lighting to be in place. But before we received the cables, we could not lay the cables along the line because we have to dig there and build the basements and also install the transformers for the different substations that we need for lighting the lamps.
Kosase also questioned UNRA for contracting IGIS, a French firm, to collect toll fees as if Ugandans have no capacity to do so.
What is so special about this road toll that requires an international company to come and do this job that local Ugandans cannot bid? Of collection of revenue, yes.
The committee was shocked to discover that the French firm collects an estimate of 2.9 billion shillings on a monthly basis and 1 billion shillings source on maintenance of the road and other items.
One. Two. Where do you put this money? Which account? Where do you bank the money? Three. This money is meant for what? As an accountability committee, we are concerned. Mere collection, without telling us where you bank the money, and the activity supposed to be funded by financed by that fund, would be leaving the whole story hanging.
Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.